Hi from Gabriele of Staticalmo, the statistical consulting service that aids your small company, organization, and also individuals to make more rigorous decisions. The video of today will have an academic cut, and as you read from the title, it deals with OnlyFans. The general question is, why do some countries have more creators than others? Do the countries have difference in terms of features that can help to explain the difference in the amount of creators? In order to do this, I collected the data of creators from this website. I leave you 5 seconds to observe the website in order to find something you find unusual. Probably you noticed at the bottom the legend for the color, and we go from zero creators to this number, and you understand that we have an artificial upper limit that will constrain us a lot in the analysis we will do. I collected the data manually because I couldn't find a more elegant and automatic way, and then I collected the population for each country because otherwise I can't create a standardized index of creators for each country, and so the analysis will not look comparable. I did it with a spreadsheet I used in another context, and I used this function to fetch the data. Then I collected data on the use for the country for illicit drugs, and the choice for this variable has some grounding in literature because unfortunately these kind of creators share a psychological background similar to sex workers, and from literature you will see that sex workers have a very specific, let's call it, psychohistory, and in this psychohistory you will find also a higher use of drugs compared to the general population, but also to other kind of professions. Then I added also a column from this very specific kind of drug, and here of course I added the source for the columns. Then I added the religion index that in some cases gave me problems. I couldn't find the data for all the countries with a single source. The rationale behind this column is the more religious the country, the more cultural obstacle to do the content creator on OnlyFans. Median income, why? Because the less the median income, the more I expect a push factor. I took the data from another spreadsheet I used in another video with a very similar function that you see in the case of population. Then I took the data for the index of liberal democracy, and the hypothesis is that the higher the index and the more the creators on OnlyFans. Something similar for gender equality, but in reverse, that means that I expect less creators if a country has higher gender equality. Wealth inequality for a similar reason that I said for median income. As you can see here, I put with this color the data cells I couldn't find in no way, and I want to underline that the number of creators also include men. I presume that the absolute majority comes from women, so this is one hypothesis of this study. I proceeded with the analysis on JASP. Here you see I did a descriptive statistics of all the variables, and as you can see, our target variable is not distributed like a normal distribution. This becomes a hint to stop immediately the analysis. Let's ignore this red flag. I created a correlation chart with various variables, and you see that more or less from here it looks like we have linear correlations. Let's go to do the actual correlations with the three different methods. This is our target column. We see that we have a moderate significant correlation with the amount of creators standardized by the population and the illicit drug use for the country, and with the liberal democracy index we have a strong significance with the Kendall tau, that is the correlation we use for finding non-linear correlations. Something similar with the gender equality index, but of course liberal democracy and this variable have a very high correlation. This is nothing new. So as you can see, we have a few significant correlations from the frequentist approach. If we do the Bayesian approach, we see that we have just two significant, but of course this obvious insight remains, so I would say we have just one significant correlation. The problem with this significance is that if we check the sequential analysis, we see that most of the points are for the hypothesis that we don't have a significant correlation. Again, we have another hint that we could stop the analysis. Let's say the problem is that we don't find significant correlations because here we don't have a normal distribution. Okay, let's transform it. Let's make the log transform, and we still don't have something that looks like a normal. In fact, the correlations with this target variable don't change with the Bayesian. Let's try anyway to do a regression with the variable that according to one method is significant, and we see that we explain just 15% of the variability of the standardized amount of creators per country. But again, this is a useless model because we used a correlation that the Bayesian methodology labeled that not significant thanks to the sequential analysis. Unfortunately, I want to remind you that in literature you find a lot of junk studies that just stops here because they see the flag, they see p-value much lower than the canonical 0.05, or I can do a publication about this finding. Let's refine a bit more the methodology. And I did this POSIT file on POSIT Cloud, that is the workbench for the language R, that is the lingua franca of statistics. I uploaded many libraries, some are useless, but I did a copy paste. I uploaded the data from the spreadsheet. Then I repeated the histogram for the target variable, and here I could do the partial correlations. That means the correlation for each variable cleaned for the effect of all the other variables. Here it's not so easy to read. We have to go to see the p-value. This is our target column, and those are the p-value we have to look. As you can see, here we have zero p-values that go below 0.05, and this is the third hint we could stop the analysis. As you can see, if I just do a linear Spearman correlation, and the Spearman correlation is the kind of correlation more robust to outliers, we have a significant correlations. We see them here. This is moderate, this is a little, and this is strong. More or less it's the same of what we saw on JASP. But as I said multiple times, different tools give different conclusions. So you have to know which are the more rigorous tools to use in an analysis. Let's try to do a transform again on the target variable so that it looks more like a normal, because this is like an exponentially negative, so it can give us problems. I tried this kind of transform that looks artificial, but let's see. Here we have something that looks like a normal. Is it enough? No, we have to rerun the correlations to see if we have some results. Again, we go up, we repeated the correlation partial with the Spearman method. We see the column of p-value. At this point we don't have anymore the target variable in the first column, but at the last. So this is our target variable. Again, you see no value below 0.05. Of course, this is the variable itself, so it is significant. Another hint, we could stop the analysis here. This is the final, but as also lawyers know, after 3 ints, let's discuss now why we have these results. The first one comes from here. We have like an artificial limit on the amount of creators. I contacted this site already to ask explanation or if they could update the data, because also you see that we have a lot of countries with too low or no data. I find, for example, very, very, very unusual that a country like the United Arab Emirates, that have a very favorable tax regime, have no data. This is too weird. But then I did another research. I searched the total amount of OnlyFans creators, and here, 1 million. If we do the sum of this column, we have 150k. So you understand that we have low data quality. I tried to use other sites similar to this one, but I couldn't find higher quality for data. The only solution for now seems to have an advanced scraper that logins into OnlyFans with an account, performs a search for country, and scrapes all the data. In this video you saw what it means to have low quality of data. Statisticians and also other kind of professional figures say garbage in, garbage out. I provided also a possible solution to improve the data quality and have meaningful analysis. Of course, we could also add other columns. In the case you have a business model where what you earn depends by the amount of users of your service, but not an e-commerce, you can contact me so that we can study together which features of countries can lead people to your service. I hope you found this video useful. Bye, and see you the next time.